Hi folks, I'm Ian Baker, the product specialist here at American RV in Grand Rapids, Michigan. And today I'm here to tell you all about the 2018 Keystone Passport 2520 RL. It's a great couples coach. Let's go ahead and start on the outside here. We'll look at some of the features out here and then we'll head on in. One of the first things you notice is this. This is your propane tank cover. Right inside here are your two 20 pound propane tanks. Very easy to get to. You just undo these two thumb screws, lift up the door, and you can get right down in there. Behind that, you will notice the rails here for your battery, and it is large enough you can have two batteries on this coach, which is great, especially if you like to do a lot of boondocking. Then coming up the front here is the black diamond plating. This helps protect the front end from some of the rocks and debris that get thrown up by your tow vehicle. On the far side, you will see a light in case you are hooking up or disconnecting at night. And then right down below there, you will see the solar prep. So again, if you want a boondock, you want that solar, not a problem. Just buy the panels, plug it in right there, and it will start to trickle charge your battery. When we come around to this side here, we can take a look at the pass-through. You will notice that it does have a covered hinge here. That way you won't get a bunch of rust coming down your door. Also magnetic, so it's nice and easy to put up. You're not gonna have any tabs that break off on you. One of the things I love about Passport Pass-Through is how big it is. Look at that huge storage you get up front here. LED light in there, you can see the aluminum framing and nice wide doors. So if you have larger items like some of your chairs, they can slide in there a lot easier than a lot of your other travel trailers. Let's drop down underneath real quick. Something I like to talk about is the frame on here. If you notice these guys right here, all the way throughout, those are huck bolts because this utilizes a huck bolt frame. Huck bolt has some advantages over a welded frame. One, the number one place that your frame rusts out at is right at those weld points. So by eliminating those welds, you eliminate the chance for those to rust out. Also, if you ever do have any kind of damage, the huck bolt frame is a lot easier to repair than your standard welded frame, meaning it will cost you less money. If we take a look at the sidewall here, you'll notice the beautiful laminated sidewall, nice curve on the front end to help with aerodynamics there too. Also, big power awning, just touch a button to roll that out, same thing to have it go right back in. It does have an adjustable pitch on there and an LED light strip underneath, so that way you don't have to get up there and hang up your Christmas lights. Getting into the 2520 is very simple. Right here is your easy grab handle. This does fold. This will ensure you have nice secure grip from the first step all the way into the coach or when you're coming out. Three steps on here as well. That way the first one is nice and low, so if you have bad knees, it is still easy to get in and out of here. If we take a look right down below, the Passport utilizes what they call load equalization axles, which is really just a fancy name for a spread axle system. But it is a great system. Essentially what it is, when you have those widespread axles, it helps reduce sway there. That way you get better towability, especially in conjunction with the unit being lighter weight. Also, you have aluminum alloy rims, so they're not going to rust up on you. Less chance for any kind of corrosion there, too. Also underneath, something else you can't see, this unit does have a fully enclosed and heated underbelly. Not that you'd need it on a beautiful day like today, but if it is colder out, maybe it's early spring or late fall, and at night it starts to dip below those freezing temperatures, as long as you have the furnace running, it's going to shoot hot air down below, which will make sure your tanks and lines are heated so they don't freeze up on you. Right here is an outside electrical outlet, so if you need to plug anything in, that is the place to do it. Come on back here, a couple quick things I want to talk about. One is this right here, good extra storage outside. You can see that right there. Gotta love extra storage, even though you have that big pass-through. I do like they give you this too, again, just nice and quick and easy to get at. Up top, one thing I forgot to mention there are the speakers. So if you want to listen to music outside, you can do that. Those are controlled by your multimedia center inside, but it is Bluetooth capable. When we come around to the back here, this is an outside grill mount. This unit does come with a grill. When the manufacturer ships it, it comes under the bed, but this is great. You can hook it on right here to spin this around. Then right underneath there is a propane quick connect. So that way you can just use your big 20 pound bottles rather than having to buy the separate small little green ones. Right here is your spare tire mounted on the bumper. It does have the cover on here to make sure that's in good shape. You have a nice window right here, so you are able to see. If you have a beautiful view out the back, you can enjoy it in this camper. And then up top in the center, you will see this unit does have the backup camera prep. So that way, if you do want a backup camera, it is a lot easier to have that installed. Welcome to the inside of the 2018 Keystone Passport 2520RL. This particular model is in the driftwood interior. Let's start off right over here. This is something I like that Passport does in a lot of their floor plans. This one happens to be right as soon as you come in the door. And take a look, you get this great versatile storage space. You'll see right up top, you have a nice hanging rod. So if you want to hang some clothes up there or jackets, you can do that. Removable shelves here so you can take those out. But myself personally, I'd probably use this as pantry space. But again, whatever you want, you can kind of custom tailor it to your needs. Right next to that is our refrigerator and freezer combo. You can see that's nice and big. You have a cutout here if you have some taller items like a half gallon of OJ. This unit does run off both propane and electric and also has automatic switchover. Moving in a little bit further, microwave right here. There's the weight of the unit, 4,920 pounds, so it's under that 5K mark, which is nice. Your hood right here with a light and fan. Underneath, of course, is your three-burner Atwood cooktop. I personally like Atwood products. The cooktop here has great flame control, nice and easy to use. And then underneath is the oven as well. Moving over a little bit further, take a look here. This is something I like to point out of how much countertop space you have in this smaller camper. That's a lot of counter space, especially in a camper that's under 5,000 pounds. And they give you the dual sink top covers here to use as additional prep space. These are cutting board quality, so if you want to flip them over, use them as cutting boards, by all means, you can do that. Double bowl sink though, larger one on the left, smaller here on the right, and the high-rise faucet. You'll see you have not one, but two windows here to really let in a lot of natural light, as well as give you a decent view outside. Right up top here, you'll see you also have two LED lights. In fact, you actually have LED lights throughout the entire coach here. The advantage of LED lights is they don't put out near the heat, and they use a fraction of the power. So, as I mentioned, we were outside with the dual batteries and the solar prep. If you're planning on boondocking, then having LED lights is a huge advantage, almost a must in my opinion. Also, you have dual electrical outlets. You do have one right back here as well as another one hiding right up there. So you have a couple different places you can plug in coffee makers, toasters, things of that nature. Take a look up top here. You have beautiful cabinetry, raised panel cabinetry here in the kitchen with your brushed nickel pulls. We open that up, you can see you have excellent space up here. Just a ton of pantry space, good storage right up there. If we take a look underneath here, you have good storage underneath the sink and dual full extension ball bearing drawers. Look how nice and long those are. Really allows for a lot of different items in there. You know, perfect for some of, you know, not just your silverware, but some of your larger items like your spatulas, things like that. Along the back here is a jackknife sofa. This is a great comfortable spot to sit. You'll see they do have these removable armrests. I personally, even though, you know, they're just lightweight, basically pillows, I really like they did include them because if you've ever sat in a jackknife sofa without armrests, it's kind of uncomfortable. So having those there is really nice. Also, if you take a look right underneath here, you'll see you have good storage, nice and easy to access. You just lift this guy up, and then this does drop down into a bed as well for additional sleeping space. You'll see you do have an end table right over here, again with another electrical outlet. So if you need to plug in cell phones, tablets, things like that, you're able to do it there. This is the big rear picture window I showed you when we were outside, and then an additional window right over here to the side. Of course, LED reading light there. Then in the back, you have this, all the storage up top. You have the tinted glass here, which I like too. Helps kind of break things up a little. But good storage all along there. Perfect for board games, everything else you want to stick up in there. Now, if we take a look over here, this is our slide-out U-shaped dinette. Again, this is the driftwood interior we're looking at here. A couple things I like about the U-dinette, and a couple in particular that Passport does. One is this right here. The fact you have this leatherette here on the bottom is really nice, especially if you have any kids, you know, or just it makes cleanup a lot easier. If you're a messy eater, I can be sometimes too. It's nice just to be able to clean this up and not have to worry about your cloth getting messy. Also, you have a big table in here. A lot of times you'll see this U-dinette, and it's this huge U-dinette with this teeny tiny table that you can't really use. So having this nice big table here is great. It allows everyone to sit around, have a meal together, play games together. It just is very usable. Also, if you have any guests that want to stay the night, while the jackknife sofa does drop down into a bed, it's not a very large one. The U-dinette, however, when you drop this down into a bed, you can easily sleep two adults here. Underneath, you have easy access to your storage. You can lift up the cushion if you want and get to it that way, but having the doors on the side is, again, just much easier. You'll also notice windows all the way around here. Of course, a light right up top. One other thing I do want to mention, if you take a look at the ceiling real quick, as I mentioned, you have LED lights there. But this is your AC, it is ducted, but this one has a quick dump option, which is really nice. So as you're loading or unloading, you can just open this up and all of your cool air will pour right into this room to help cool things down a little. Then when you're all set up, just flip it back over and it will run back through your ductwork. Right over here is your entertainment center. Of course, TV right there in the center. This is the multimedia center I talked about when we were outside. This unit is your radio, CD, and DVD player, so if you want to watch a movie, you can pop it in right there. So you have a cubby hole here with some connections. You'll see you have dual USB port in there. Storage right here underneath. And then you have some additional storage right here up top. In the bathroom of the 2520, you'll see your foot flush lever toilet here with plenty of leg room. Right up above that, you have your vent fan there to help moisture quickly escape. Right next to that is a nice big neo-angle shower. You can see these shower doors are in a roller track, which is really nice because that way all the water will go right straight down into your shower pan rather than dripping all over your floor when you get out. Also, you'll see some shelves in there and a hand wand as well as a nice big skylight, letting in natural light and giving you additional headspace. Right over here is your mirrored medicine cabinet. You can see storage right behind the mirror there. Down below, you have your sink top with electrical outlet and additional storage underneath that. So right as soon as you walk in, your control panel is conveniently located right here. A couple of great things about this, obviously it's nice and small, very easy to read. You can see your tank monitoring system on there. One of the things I do want to point out though is the water heater. This has an Atwood water heater, and this particular water heater you can use gas or electric or both for higher recovery. Also an advantage of the Atwood water heater is you don't have an anode rod, which means you're not going to have to constantly replace it. It uses an aluminum tank, so that way even if it's aggressive water, it will be fine. And again, in my opinion, that's a big advantage. You know, that's something that's one less thing you have to remember on the maintenance side. On the other side of the entranceway here, you can take a look at this. You have some awesome storage, kind of a built-in coat rack right here. And then down below, you have some nice shelves there, which is a great place to put shoes. Hang your jacket up, take your shoes off, stuff them in there. That way they're out of the way. As we step into the bedroom of the 2520, something I want to show you is this right here, and that is the door. Even in a lightweight model, Passport still puts in a nice slider door rather than a curtain or a curtition. That way you get a little bit of extra privacy if you do have guests. Another big thing I love about the bedroom is the bed itself. This is a residential queen size bed, so it's a full 60 by 80 inches here. That way, if you are a taller person, you can sleep here comfortably without your feet hanging halfway off the bed. On both sides of the bed, you'll see a window here for a nice cross breeze, and this one is an emergency exit here. And then on either side of the bed, you have great storage. You see a mirrored wardrobe. When you open that up, there's a hanging rod in there, a shelf up top, and a little nightstand down below. This side does have a little bit bigger shelf over here. And then you have electrical outlets on both sides of the bed. So if you need to charge phones, plug in a CPAP, something like that, you have the capability to do that. Then up top here, again, you see the tinted glass, and you have additional storage going all the way across. Lastly, if you're one that likes to watch TV before bed, that's not an issue. You do have TV hookups right here. But all right, folks, that wraps it up. Again, this is a 2018 Keystone Passport 2520RL. This particular model is in the driftwood interior. If you're interested in this RV and you'd like price and availability, I recommend you give us a call here at American RV, or you can take a look at our website, which is AmericanRV.com. Thanks again for watching. I'm Ian Baker. I can't wait to see you on the road to freedom.